Well, thank you everyone for coming to our seminar today. It's my great pleasure to present our today's speaker, Professor Grudzki, and the title of his talk is here, Statistics of Eigen Values of and Eigen Vectors of Tuples Matrices. Please, Professor Grudzki, go ahead. Thank you.
Okay. Good afternoon, colleagues. It's a very good opportunity for me to make report in this community. Thank you, Alexei. Thank you, Vladislav. And my talk about the asymptotic of eigenvalues may be, if I will have time, about asymptotic of eigenvector of large tuples matrices. This field has a large history over 100 years. First of all, we can mention the number version of Segur theorems about the asymptotic of distribution of eigenvalues, about the asymptotic of determinants of tuples matrix. We can mentioned the works about asymptotic of maximum and minimum eigenvalues, about the limit set of eigenvalues, but investigation of about of individual asymptotic of all the eigenvalues, eigenvector or tuples matrix started only recently. This field has 12 years history. И my talk about survey of this new field. Okay, a little bit detail. So we have a tuples matrix. Tuples matrix is matrix with the same number of each diagonals. This number are generated of the symbol. Symbol is the function is defined on unit circle, on unit circle, such that these numbers are the Fourier coefficients of this function, of this symbol, of this symbol. Okay, if we have n not very large, for example, 1,000, it's possible to calculate eigenvalues on the with the usual numerical program of linear algebras in few seconds. But if we have n very large, for example, in statistical physics, we can reach n equal to 10 and power 10. We have no alternative of asymptotics theory. On the other hand, if we end not very large, saying hundreds or dozens, this asymptotic method works very good. It's very comfortable to have asymptotic expansion, because if we can necessity to calculate eigenvalues for many different values of n, it will be very effective. Okay, we have a large application. We have a large application of this theory. The first of all is application to the numerical solution of differential and integral equation. By the way, in the last years, very popular on boundary problem for the partial differential equation with fractional derivative. In this case, we have application with the symbol that have a that have a singularity of the power types, of the power types, it's really interesting and delicate problem. We have a lot of other applications and easing models, stochastic process, signal processing, quantum mechanics, and so on, so on. This formulas, this theory has a theoretical quality of significance. The first of all, with the help of this formula, we can study the structure of location of eigenvalues, very important. So we have analyzed distance between eigenvalues. We have analyzed. We can look for points of concentration of eigenvalues. And it's very important, on the base of this formula, it's possible to construct very effective fast numerical algorithm. Okay. Raise the following question. Why we have no article that devoted for this subject, for this problem until last 10 or 12 years. In the answer in my for this question have two main reasons. The first, the problem about the asymptotic of all eigenvalues has two parameters, the large asymptotic parameter n, and second parameter hota. Hota is number of eigenvalues. So we must to construct asymptotic formula by asymptotic by n uniformly by hota, uniformly in hota, where the hota is located entry one in n. It's different, difficult. In the second, distance between neighboring eigenvalues can be very small. If we have normal case, if eigenvalue is located far from of singularity of the symbol. In this case, we can distance in the between neighboring eigenvalues like one over n. But if we have special case, if eigenvalues are located near the singularities, we can observe the distance between these eigenvalues very small, like one over n power gamma, where gamma can be large enough. Entonces, this problem is delicate enough. Okay, the first direction that I...
Excuse me, please. May I ask? The second case is probably gamma is greater than one. Am I right?
Gamma then one, gamma...
So do you select another special case where gamma is less than one?
Less than one.
Mm-hmm. Do you select such a case?
Okay. See, yes. Yes. Entonces, so the first direction that I should like talk as so-called simple loop case is case if the symbol of the Toeplitz matrix is symbol, if we consider the symbol like the real variable, angle variable, if variable phi is changed from 0 to p, this function has exactly two interval of monotonicity. Entonces, so as in this case, symbol has exactly one minimum, exactly one maximum, and this minimum and maximum are simple. That means that the second derivative of the in these points does not equal to zero. The first article on this direction is article of 2010, our article, where we have considered the case of polynomial symbol. After that, David Krasovsky in our two works, we have considered more general cases in article in 2000, in article to in the last article, in the last article, we have considered the case if symbol has only one derivative. Okay. We formulate the main result in this direction. Okay, we consider the symbol that belonging to Wiener algebra, famous Wiener algebra of unit circle. It's very popular algebra in this theory. We are considering the case of real valued symbol. In this case, we know that Toeplitz matrix, the Toeplitz apparatus is after Hunkel gauged. And the second condition is condition that you have said above, this symbol has the only two interval, the monotonicity. Monotonicity is simple minimum and simple maximum. Okay, this class we denote simple loop with number alpha. It's easy to see that R belongs to this alpha, so this symbol has integral part alpha of derivative. So if we have alpha equal to one, we have that symbol has only one derivative. Okay. We have considered this class for alpha major or equal to one, and we impose one more condition one. This condition something like to have the second derivation in the point of maximum of minimum. Okay. So we formulate the result in the case of symmetric symbol, of the symmetric symbol. In this case, the results looks more nice. The symmetric case, it means that function is symmetric relatively s equal to p, relatively the middle of the interval. Okay. We introduce the variable s as variable such that the HDS a symbol of the angle variable equal to lambda. Lambda is the spectral parameter, and lambda belong to the image of the symbol. It's well known that all eigenvalues for the continuous real wages functions allocation inside the image, inside the minimum and maximum of the symbol. Okay, for this lambda, for this S, we generate the function beta S, beta sigma at S. We consider the difference, the sigma and the S. This symbol is simple loop symbol. So this difference has exactly two solution and point S and minus S. If we divide this difference for the simplest polynomial, for the simplest function that have the same zero. So the function beta is positive function. It's very comfortable in point of view this theory, because the Toeplitz operator, Toeplitz matrix with this symbol is invertible, is one side, and other side the function beta has the Wiener-Hopf factorization, standard Wiener-Hopf factorization. We introduce the function gamma of s. This function is defined with the help of integral. This integral is taken in principal value sense. And this function comes from Wiener-Hopf. This function gamma at s comes from Wiener-Hopf factorization. We can see that as difference of two logarithmic of Wiener-Hopf function, Wiener-Hopf factorization is taken in point S and minus S. Argument of Wiener-Hopf of functions in Wiener-Hopf factorization. Okay, so in terms of function gamma at S, we can formulate the main result in this direction. So let alpha more or less one and I belong to a simple loop class. Then for every n Majorca 1, all eigenvalues are distinct. See, for numbers s hota, such that lambda hota at n eigenvalues of Toeplitz matrix equal j at sn, if this numbers S hota satisfy the following nonlinear equation two. We can see that this function has a large parameter n plus one, and we have the remainder, the function delta one. As reminder, is small enough. This equation has exactly one solution for each hota between one and n. And this asymptotic equation, we can consider the approximation equation sin without delta one. This equation with a large parameter, and we can analyze in asymptotic sense this equation, and on base of this asymptotic, we can obtain the following asymptotic expression. Theorem four. Introduce the numbers d hota of n as numbers divided interval 0 p by the equidistant intervals, and the asymptotic of our eigenvalues lambda hota of n, and terminus on function g as function of the symbol, and function rk, and function rk, this function is taken of parameter delta gn. The function rk can be calculated explicitly. In Pachukal, we can see the first function R1 and R2 is reaching in terminal h и eta и their derivative. Okay, we have integral part terms of asymptotics and asymptotics. A reminder that has the order mass more greater than integer part of alpha. We can see that asymptotic equation in effective enough, and really is we have calculating the function GRK. We can apply this asymptotic expression for different value of n, and is effective enough for this case. Okay. The next direction is the symbol that do not satisfy of the condition simple loop. The simple loop is very important class in this case the structure of the asymptotic expansion very nice. If we go beyond of this class, the structure of this asymptotic equation are changing. For example, you will talk about the case of a symbol with the minimum of order four. It means that the minimum is not simple. It's not simple. We can in this case only the derivative with number four does not equal to zero, not equal zero. And when we'll see the structure of the asymptotics formulas are changed. This slide to our article on this direction, we formulate the basic results on this direction on the example simplest symbol of this direction is symbols of the kind 3, the kind 3. The symbol has a very simple formula. If we consider the symbol of the angle variable phi, only sine of the order four. For formulate our result, we introduce an linear equation 5 and equation 6. Equation la problem in this is the formulas for even eigenvalues and add eigenvalues has a little bit different form. We will consider only one case of this. This unlinear equation, for example, equation 5, is defined with the help of function phi and beta, function phi and beta. And terms of the solution of this unlinear equation, we formulate the main result in this direction. Okay. The first main theorem here. So we consider this simplest symbol. We introduce the numbers phi hota such that the image of the phi hota of our symbol equal to our eigenvalues lambda hota. And for these numbers phi, we have the following asymptotic extension. In this, the first coefficient of this equation, the number U1 hota, is not possible to calculate in the explicit form. This number is a solution of the equation 5, on inner equation 5, actually 5. Equation five. This equation is nonlinear equation, but this equation is not dependent of n. So, if you consider eigenvalues with number not very small. It means that the product n plus 2 is large enough. This tangent hyperbolic asymptotically equal to 1, and we have the exact formula for the solution of this equation. It means for the hota is not very small. We have the formulas more or less like the case of simple loop. If hota is small enough. We must look for solution of this equation. And we have for small hota, the following asymptotic equation. In this case, the parameter d go to zero. It means that number of eigenvalues relatively small, relatively the n, Here we have the following asymptotic equation, asymptotic expansion chain, asymptotic equation chain. Okay. Okay. This formula is coincides with classical formula. More exactly, the first term of this formula is coincide with the classical result of Wyndham and Parter, Wyndham and Parter. Overmore, we can construct the following term of this formulas, and it's very important. Our formula is uniformly by Hotta, such that Hotta over n go to the zero. The classical formula is is satisfied only for fixed Hotta. Okay, the following direction. It's very important to make the next step to the complex value symbols. It's very important step because in this case the Toeplitz matrix operator are not conjugates. For one hand, and for other hand, in this case, eigenvalues are complex. The main obstacle in this direction is following. In general, we does not know the limit set of eigenvalues. It means that we do not know where have to look for the eigenvalues area of the complex plane where allocated eigenvalues. But exists one relatively simple case, if we know this limit set of the eigenvalues as symmetric complex value symbol. In this case, the image of the symbol is the curve of complex plane without interior, because we passed this curve in forward direction if phi is changed from zero to p, and come direction if we change phi from P to P. We consider the example, numerical example. We have this symbol, symmetric symbol of this on this slide. This symbol is not very simple because the symbol has two singular points, t equal to 1, equal to minus 1. In this point, we have two derivatives, but does not have the third derivative. Okay. If you calculate the eigenvalues, we have the following picture. The blue curve is image of the symbol, in the red point in the eigenvalues. And in this case, we can see the first. All eigenvalues are complex, and these eigenvalues are located near the near this curve, watch arise several questions. Where are locating eigenvalues? Above of the curve or above of the curve or the side of the curve? Watch distance between the eigenvalues in this curve image of the symbol. Okay. Our formulas, our asymptotic formulas that you will say few seconds later, will give to us answer for all of these questions. Okay. Consider the class of the symbol that is the direct generalization of the symbol loop class of the symbol group class. You can consider the symbol that belong to the Wiener class W alpha, and this condition is more or less like simple loop condition, include that the second derivative in the point 0 and p, the second derivative does not equal to 0. Okay. I have no opportunity to talk about the method of the justification of our formula, but it's this method is deep enough. This method is based on the some theorems of the operator theory, some theorems of the complex analysis, but in this case, the complex value case, we have one problem. We will consider the nonlinear equation, this nonlinear equation in complex plane, not in real interval, but in some complex domain. It's some complex domain. But our symbol is not obligatory have analytic continuation in some region as symbol that has only several derivatives. So the main idea is following: we change the symbol A by symbol AN. AN is symbol, is polynomial of the N order. It's really in the Toeplitz matrix of dimension N has are defined by two n numbers to define this polynomial. So the Toeplitz matrix of symbol A and Toeplitz matrix of symbol of AN are coinciding. See, so and we have the now we have the function, analytical function, but we get additional parameter AN, and all our theorem, all our results would be uniformly YN, would be uniform YN. For example, instead of the interval 0P, we must consider the one strip PN. This strip has the width like 1/N, instead of image of our symbol, we have to consider the image of this strip by action of our polynomial function Cn of n. We must prove some delicate theorem. For example, lemma 1 is lemma that this map, the map GNF, is comfort map, is bijection for n large enough. Our function, our symbol head must be some continuation to the strip, small strip, and this lemma to give to us this continuation. It is something like Taylor series with the reminder that has the following estimation. So after that we have construct the function BN as analog of the function beta, but here the series of function IN minus lambda is complex series, and function theta n of lambda is analog of our function n in case of a simple loop. But this point phi is complex value. We introduce the point the quota n like in case on the simple loop. If the center of the small disk P hota at n is disk where our eigenvalues are located. The number cn is cn go to the zero if n go to the infinity, and cn would be calculation the exact form. So after that we have the analog of main theorem in the case of simple loop. We have that all eigenvalues are different. We have a nonlinear equation 11. This equation is equation in the strip, not equation for the interval. And it's possible to prove that equation one has the exactly one solution in this disk, in the domain P hota n. Okay, the base of this theorem, we have the asymptotic equation. This asymptotic equation is direct analog of the main result of simple loop. Okay, И it's possible to get the famous result about the first eigenvalues, about the first eigenvalues is analog of the classical result, but I repeat this result is uniformly by Hotta, such that Hotta is small enough, mass exactly, Hotta in quadrant, Hotta in power 2 divide for n go to the 0 if n go to the infinity, Okay. Okay, this slide is devoted to the problem about the location eigenvalue, This formula is allows us to understand where allocated lambda Hotta, where the located eigenvalue, if image the function eta is positive, lambda Hotta is located above our curve, if image of this function of this number is negative, this eigenvalue, is located below the curve that generates of image of the our symbol. And the last formula is the distance, between the eigenvalue and image of the our symbol. Okay. Numerical example. We analyze the error, relative error for our extension, the first extension that contain two terms, is the second extension S extension contain three terms. And this error are shown in this table. This table is example that I have shown anterior. We have the following. Even n equal to 20, and only for the first formula we have is approximation of good enough. But if we have the approximation with three term, if for n equal to 300, we have very small error. So these formulas for this case and for this case of simple loop are very effective. Okay, the next direction has some interesting history in 209 in his article, Leo Kadanov and his co-authors published his article. In this article, they has the conjecture, they conjecture some asymptotic equation for the eigenvalues and eigenvector. In very popular case complex value case, if symbol has the singularity of power type. Okay, a conjectured sum asymptotic formulas, and they have checked these formulas in numerically way with the help of several numerical experiments. Okay, after that, in our article with Albrecht Böttcher and Manuel Bagoya, we have proved a precise this conjugate for the one class symbol of such type. In 200, in article in 212, we have considered the case if eigenvalues allocated outside of small neighborhood of the singularity point. In article in 219, we have considered the case if lambda j is allocated inside the small neighborhood of the singularity point. Okay. Our symbol has the following form, and we have the power singularity, and function phi of t is analytic function. This class of the symbol belong the symbol of the class Leo Kadanov. Okay. So in this case, we have obtained the following asymptotic extension. In this case, it's very important. Alpha is fractional number. In this case, we have the following asymptotics. And we consider asymptotics of other type. The second chair of asymptotic is logarithmic, contains the logarithmic term. So we can say that this two term is coincide with conjecture of Leo Kadanov his Kaftas, and the third term is some additional term. We illustrate this asymptotic formula, asymptotic extension, with the following picture. On this picture, we can see blue line is the patch of the image of the symbol. Black point is eigenvalue calculated by MATLAB as exact eigenvalues. The red cross is the approximation with the help of the first two terms, conjecture of Leo Kadanov is his chapter, and the the green cross is the approximation with the help of three Chermov asymptotic forms. Okay. So I will say several words about asymptotic of eigenvectors, about asymptotic of eigenvectors. On this slide, we can see the article that I devoted for this subject. Investigation of asymptotic of eigenvector in the case of simple loop, in the case of symmetric symbols, in the case of the power singularity. We formulate the main result only for simple loop case. So let lambda hot n is eigen values of the duplets matrix. S hot is number such that lambda hot is image of the symbol. We introduced the numbers Z1 and Z2. Don't the function sigma 1 and sigma 2 could be calculated, but in the case of symmetric case, sigma 1 equal to S, a sigma 2 equal to minus S is very simple. We consider the inverse matrix of dimension n mass 2 of the our symbol, where symbol B is the function B. Function B is positive function, is function you recall that devoted like symbol minus A lambda divided to two simplest polynomial with those chern. And we consider the vector theta, the first column on this matrix, and the help of this vector we generated function theta of t. Okay, so we have the main theorem in this case following. The vector, the eigenvector has three terms, M, L, R. This term is very simple term, but this term for many cases is the main part of the vector, relatively to other terms is reaching with the help of following integrals. And take your attention, this exact formula. If we know the eigenvalues, we can write the formulas for eigenvector. These are not asymptotic formulas, these exact formulas. But if we change the eigenvalues, exact eigenvalues by asymptotic formulas, if we change the function theta by asymptotic way the function from the Wiener-Hall factorization, we can obtain the following asymptotic formulas. In these formulas we can function z1 and z2 S function generated by approximation of the eigenvalues, и instead on function theta, we can instead we can see the function b plus b minus is Wiener-Hof factorization on function b. So is the approximative of the eigenvector, and we can see if we have that symbol belong the W alpha, then alpha more than four, we have the following asymptotic equation where the error term lambda one has the following evaluation. That is all. Thank you for attention.
Well, thank you very much for a very nice talk. And we have time for questions, please. Any questions?
Give a comment.
Yes, please go ahead, Lars.
From the Arctic Circle. I have also during a period of my life been very interested in these stepless matrices. Maybe this is a surprise because many have seen other things I have done. And my interest was in Fourier analysis, but it's related to this also. Of course, these eigenvalue problems are connected to this also. And we created something together with Nicolau Popa. We created something like we called it matricial harmonic analysis. Mm-hmm. And this stepless matrices were the model for us, you know. They were almost like Fourier coefficients, and you could build up them. Almost like in classical Fourier analysis, you can build up matrices in this way. And we published it in a book which looks like this. It's not in World Scientific 2013, you know. It's matrix spaces and Schur multipliers, matricial harmonic analysis. And what we could create was almost something like almost all inequalities in the classical Sigmund book and such things we could do in matrix version also. It was a surprise for me when we discovered the first of these results, but the teplex matrices were central when we discovered this in some sense. And I think it's some connection with this, and because eigenvalues, of course, in Fourier analysis have very important meaning also. So this is my comment.
See, thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Maybe more questions?
And nice talk. Nice talk is my comment also.
Thank you.
Thank you.
More comments. Questions. Maybe I'll have a general wondering because Lars Erik already mentioned the connection with analysis of possibly function space theory. Since you associate your matrices somehow with Fourier coefficients, right? Mm-hmm. And then you construct the functions by these coefficients. Do you have or may you have any consequences of your result applied to a theory of function spaces, some properties of related functions constructed by these coefficients, some classes of functions.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. See. Okay. See, it's possible to get results more or less like this. In the case if symbol is belong to folder classes mm-hmm. or classes mass general is right, but the in this case arise some difficult some additional difficult, but it's problem for future.
Mm-hmm. I see. Okay, thank you. Okay, more questions, please. Well, if there are no more questions, then let's thank the speaker for a very nice talk. Thank you.